In the previous video, we talked about the Carnot cycle and the Carnot heat engine. If you haven't seen it, please watch it before watching this one to understand how a Carnot cycle works. Now we will shift our focus to Carnot refrigerators and heat pumps, all of which work on a reverse Carnot cycle. From the refrigerators and heat pumps video, we learned about these two equations, which allows us to find the coefficient of performance of any refrigerator or heat pump. These equations work for reversible or irreversible heat pumps. Here, QL is the amount of heat absorbed from a low-temperature medium, and QH is the amount of heat rejected to a high-temperature medium. When it comes to reversible refrigerators or heat pumps, we can use the temperatures of our low- and high-temperature reservoirs to calculate the COP values. In simple terms, these give us the highest COP values we can get from a refrigerator or a heat pump, and they're based on reservoir temperatures only. Keep in mind that TH and TL must be in Kelvin for this equation to work. Don't use Celsius or Fahrenheit, or you will end up with the wrong answers. We can compare COP values to figure out what type of refrigerator it is. If the reversible COP is less than the actual COP, it's an irreversible refrigerator. If it's equal, then it's a reversible refrigerator. And if it's greater than the actual COP, it's an impossible refrigerator. The same is true for heat pumps. Keep in mind that in real life, refrigerators and heat pumps will never reach the COP of reversible refrigerators or heat pumps. Since we covered the Carnot cycle in the previous video, there really isn't much else to talk about, so let's go and tackle some problems. In this problem, we have a Carnot refrigerator that needs to maintain a temperature of 3 degrees Celsius. We need to figure out the rate of heat removal. Let's start by writing down what we know. The room temperature is 22 degrees Celsius, which is our TH. The refrigerator consumes 2 kilowatts of power, and the temperature to be maintained is 3 degrees Celsius, which is our TL. Our goal is to figure out QL, which is the heat removed from our refrigerated space. The first step is to figure out the COP of this refrigerator. For that, we can use this equation. The little c represents a Carnot refrigerator. Let's plug our values in. Solving gives us the COP of this refrigerator. To figure out QL, we need to remember that COP is just the desired output divided by the required input. Here, our desired output is QL, and the required input is the power consumption. This should be familiar to you from the refrigerators and heat pumps video. Let's write this in rate form. Now we can plug our values in. We can write this in kilojoules per minute by remembering that 1 kilowatt is 1 kilojoule per second. So this tells us that 1,743 kilojoules of heat is removed every minute from the food compartment of the refrigerator. Let's take a look at this question where we have an air conditioning system running on a reverse Carnot cycle. We need to figure out the power required to operate it. Let's start by writing down what we know. The air conditioner needs to remove 750 kilojoules of heat every minute from the house to maintain it at 24 degrees Celsius. So that's our QL and TL. The outside air temperature is 35 degrees Celsius, so that's our TH. We can start by figuring out the COP of this air conditioner. Let's plug our values in. We get a COP of 27. Now, all we need to do is use the equation relating power usage with COP. Let's plug our values in. Keeping in mind that 1 kilowatt is 1 kilojoule per second and there are 60 seconds in a minute, we can write this in kilowatts. And that's our answer. Let's take a look at this problem where we have a heat pump operating on a Carnot cycle. We need to figure out the temperature of the reservoir from which heat is absorbed and the heating load provided by this heat pump. Let's start by writing down what we know. The COP of the heat pump is 8.7. It keeps a space heated at 24 degrees Celsius, so that's TH, and it consumes 2.15 kilowatts of power, which is our power N. Our goal is to find TL and QH. We can use this equation to figure out the TH. Let's plug our values in. Now we can tidy it up and then solve for TL. To figure out QH, we can use this equation. It's the same as before, desired output divided by the required input, but in the case of heat pumps, our desired output is QH. Let's plug our values in. Solving gives us our answers. Let's take a look at this interesting problem. We have a Carnot heat engine. The work output of this engine is used to drive a Carnot refrigerator that removes heat from a refrigerated space. We need to figure out the maximum rate of heat removal from the refrigerated space and the total rate of heat rejection to the air. Let's start by writing down what we know. The Carnot heat engine receives heat from a reservoir at 900 degrees Celsius, so that's our TH. The rate of heat it receives is 800 kilojoules per minute, that's our QH. The waste heat is rejected to the air, which is at 27 degrees Celsius, that's our TL. The refrigerator keeps the refrigerated space at negative 5 degrees Celsius and transfers heat to the same air as the heat engine, which means the 27 degrees Celsius ambient temperature is the TH for our refrigerator. I used a subscript HE to represent heat engine and R to represent the refrigerator values. Let's draw a diagram to understand this better. So our heat engine is here. Then we have the high temperature reservoir at 900 degrees Celsius here. Then we have the ambient air at the bottom at 27 degrees Celsius. It also receives 800 kilojoules of energy per minute from the high temperature reservoir. Then we have QL, which is the heat dissipated into the ambient air. Lastly, the heat engine produces power, so we have power output here. Now let's draw the usual diagram for a refrigerator. So we have the ambient air at the top and the refrigerated space at the bottom. We also know that the power output from the heat engine is the power input to our refrigerator, so we can move it to right here. We also know they both share the same ambient air, so we can move the refrigerated space up here and have the same common ambient air for both. Don't forget, the refrigerator takes heat away from the refrigerated space, so the arrow must be flipped. Let's tackle this problem by first figuring out the power output of this heat engine. To do that, we need to know the efficiency of this engine. We can use the efficiency of a Carnot engine equation to do that. Let's plug our values in. So this is our thermal efficiency. Now we can figure out the power output of the heat engine using this equation. So this power output value we found is the power input for our refrigerator. Now we're going to switch to the Carnot refrigerator and figure out its COP. Keep in mind that TH for the refrigerator is the ambient temperature and TL is negative 5 degrees Celsius. Let's plug our values in and solve. Now that we have the COP, we can use that to figure out the rate of heat removal from the refrigerated space. For that, we can use this equation. Let's plug in our values. Remember, the power output of our heat engine is the power input of our refrigerator. Solving tells us how much heat is removed. The next part of our question is to figure out the total rate of heat rejected into the ambient air. So let's first figure out the amount of heat rejected to the air by the heat engine. For that, we need to remember that for a cyclic device, net work output can be found by subtracting QL from QH. So we can plug our values in and solve for QL. Next, we need to figure out the heat removed by the refrigerator. We can use the same equation as before with work input instead of work output, but remember, the output of our heat engine is our input to the refrigerator. Let's plug our values in. Solving gives us the heat removed by the refrigerator, which is then moved to the ambient air. So now, all we need to do is add the heat rejected by the heat engine and the heat moved by the refrigerator. Adding the two values gives us the total rate of heat rejected to the ambient air. That should cover the types of problems you will face when it comes to Carnot refrigerators and heat pumps. Thanks for watching and best of luck with your studies.